Hello everyone, this is Princescyther for VGgameplay. I'm joined by Raiko. Hello, Raiko.
Hello.
By a satellite ink? Uplink? Ink, satellite ink.
It's that new magic formula that binds us.
This was a confusing mission as well. This is mission 6. Not level 6. Now, when we say mission 6, it's like the mission, not the level. Because it's divided up into levels, so it might get confusing for some people who are like, this ain't mission 6.
One arm.
She's so strong.
This immediately made me think of Metal Gear Solid, actually. Metal Gear Solid 2 over the first one.
Well, the arrival of Raiden in the second.
Well, yeah, not Elvis and Raiden, but the fact that they're starting on a sort of ship with that pool, yeah.
Yeah.
I get what you mean now, yeah. But, not that I genuinely thought you thought Raiden and Elvis looked the same.
No, in the plant. Well, I hate the amount of alarms in this. So
I'll tell you what, mate. I don't know if you know, but as long as you don't go through the door after you've killed someone, they won't go for the alarm. They'll go for either the door or for the dead body. They won't set the alarm off.
That's all good. I'm cool with that.
I like this mission.
Know.
Other
I don't
than
know
this
what
bit.
I was doing here.
Yeah, like, again, trial and error.
What the hell? Yeah.
Press everything.
Yeah, it is. If there was like a puzzle to that, like pressing those buttons, I probably would have given up. I can't be bothered with puzzles like that. It really annoys me in video games.
I mean, they're a bit illogical.
There's no clear way like of knowing. Which I thought when I first played this, there wasn't going to be in there. Give me a disc.
I didn't even let him finish.
Punch.
It's a hook.
She doesn't always punch. Sometimes she uses like the palm of her hand to take people out.
I wasn't so confident about hitting them. I thought like, if I miss them once, that's it, they're going to run away. So I opened the door and just stood in the doorway so they couldn't get past and wait for them to come at me.
I like this little bit here, where this guy like turns against him.
Yeah.
I thought that was pretty. That's a little cool little touch.
It's a cool touch, but when you're not expecting it, and they get killed.
That's my whole thing. Like, that's annoying. But it's things like that that are kind of like that worry me about Watch Dogs. Like little scenario moments like that. Like the trailers for Watch Dogs. So many of those. You know, the first time you see them, like, oh my god, that looks like it's, you know, just being done because it's cool AI. But eventually, you're like, oh, I've seen that. That's, you know, it's like, how many times can something like that happen in Watch Dogs before it gets boring, that kind of thing. Don't know if you saw my Facebook message about that the other day.
I did.
On VG Gameplay Facebook page, visit it now. But yeah, on there. That's what I was trying to explain. It's kind of hard to do it in written word, but...
Yeah, no, I know what you mean, but it is a case where the game's going to be scripted like that, so I don't think those moments are going to be common, but they're going to be scripted, so they're not going to be as cool as if you did that yourself.
Exactly, yeah.
It's not going to be as like, whoa.
Yeah, exactly. But I mean, even like in the trailers, like some of those moments in there were scripted, and I was like, oh my god, it looks so amazing, and like, yeah, but that's going to happen that way.
My concern is that when during that scene where he's running through that alleyway chasing someone, that was just out and out Assassin's Creed, that was. And it's taken them 5 games and they still haven't sorted out the controls for that game. I mean, they're more than functional, but the amount of times you end up doing something you don't want to do. And it might technically be your fault, but it's the sort of thing that after about like 80 hours of gameplay, you're still making that mistake, so it's something that needs to be changed. I say 80 hours, that's over the whole series, not over one game. They're not that big. But that's a slight concern, but I imagine climbing and pole vaulting and stuff isn't going to be a common theme in the game.
No. So,
it does look good, but if that tech demo is running on the PS4, it's not.
Yeah.
Stunning in any way, is it?
No. It was stunning when you first saw it because you didn't know that. And you're like, oh my god, that looks amazing. How is this even possible on a PS3? But then, yeah. I don't know, man.
It's something that I don't think it's been discussed a lot, but at the minute, there doesn't seem to be many next generation exclusive titles. It seems like all the big budget games are going to be multi-platform with the old consoles.
Mm.
Which means there's going to be a lot of big games that don't really take advantage. Better. That was.
Probably. That guy's face was like covered in red. It got jammed again.
This
is such a confusing layout, this level.
I like how it looks, but it is just a string of corridors.
Yeah.
I mean, why do you have to walk down a corridor this bloody long to get to this room here? That's all that's down here, and it takes about 2 minutes. You would never build it like that.
It's got a snorkel on. Follow you. You follow me, Elvis.
Yeah, that's a good point. Never let him bloody lead.
I do, though.
We're dead. You let him lead so you can see his ass.
I think I forgot where I was headed. I think I forgot where I was going, so I thought, well, I'm going to follow him because he knows.
I originally, not many people will know this, but you will, but I was working on a video game in my final year of uni, which was like a third-person sort of Tomb Raider-esque sci-fi thing.
Was that the one with the funny arm guy?
Yeah, with the guy whose animations hadn't been finished. But my level design, my artwork ended up looking a lot like this originally before I made
can
it.
Can we put
right.
that on VGgameplay now? Have you still got it? Can you do a playthrough of it?
It's not really
a fully functional game in that sense, but
I don't think it can be playable anymore. I don't know. Oh no, of course it can because someone's got it running.
If I
can get hold of Unreal 3 on my laptop, then I can do it myself. I can capture it myself, which would be worth doing. I'd rather capture it straight from screen rather than the footage I've got, which is recorded on a phone.
Yeah.
It doesn't function very well. It's quite embarrassing, and
I ended up doing
a lot of the visual work myself.
Yeah. Right, like, you can't really call it embarrassing. I mean, how many other people who are watching VG gameplay have actually made
do that
in game?
Yeah, fair enough. But that's the problem with some of the work like that I've done at uni is that you end up, you have a goal and you know you're capable of doing it, but then it gets pulled back, like reeled back in because people aren't pulling their weight or you don't have enough time or you're doing too many other bits of work. And it's really frustrating finishing a piece of work, getting a good mark for it, because I got I got an amazing score for that work. I got like 71% or something, which for a third year project was pretty damn good. Mm. And at the same time, it's not something I really want to show. It looks a bit awful. It looks awful. But I'm proud in the sense that I did a lot of work. A lot of work on that. Hours and hours. Because we
put it on your Raiko channel, didn't you? Is it still up there?
It was on there, but I think I took it down after a while because someone posted better footage and then that's disappeared, so.
You should have downloaded it.
I want to talk about it more, but I'll save it until we get some footage sorted. Because this isn't the time, place.
This is plenty of time.
This is a much better game. Talk about this one.
Okay.
The reason I bought it.
Amount of enemies in this fucking place. Yeah, go back to your original point anyway.
Exploding boxes. Yeah, my original point is that the game looked a bit like this, actually, with pipes going across the ceiling, the curved walls with the pillars on them, things like that. It was very similar, and having not played this game, I've only just picked up on that.
Yeah, you thought they were copying you.
They copied me, man, from the future. I hope the government don't want to use
this ship anytime soon. Boom. Was Peter Molyneux on your rating thing? Was he like grading your work? And he was like,
you know, he actually helped make it, but he wasn't pulling as well. he did the character animations.
So he's just got his arms stretched out. Yeah, they weren't really stretched out. They were kind of like pointed forwards, weren't they? He's like, as if they were like running, like when you put your like hands out in like blades, but they just weren't moving. If I remember correctly, that's how I remember it. Anyway.
That's because one guy worked on the character and another guy worked on the character animations. The thing is, this guy did about an hour's worth of work for the project altogether because he claimed he was too busy, and he might have been, to be fair. So I'm not holding it against him, but his animations were absolutely awful. So we were like, okay, let's just use the default bog standard running animation in Unreal Tournament because it's built into the engine.
Yeah.
So we're like, okay, and then we tried hooking it up to this character, and we got the legs moving, but the arms were just out in front as if he was holding a massive tray with plates on.
Yeah, that's what it does look like, actually.
And anyway, yeah, it,
this
enough of that.
Sucks. I hate this.
This mission isn't fun, but I do like the look of it.
Oh, I hate it.
It's not the best, no, but
hate you, dear. Did
I can see why.
It's all red, like Virtual Boy.
I wonder if that was meant to be the reference. You know that Retro City, Rampage can be played in like Virtual Boy mode,
yeah,
can't it?
Yeah, yeah.
Do you want to?
I like playing on just like a NES graphics. That'll do me. I did play it on a Game Boy, Greg, because it has like a Game Boy feel to it.
Yeah.
I did play it on that for a little while. It actually looked quite good in Game Boy.
I'm with you. I don't think the game's amazing, but I like the fact that he's put all those filters in. That must have taken forever, absolutely forever. Don't know if it's worth the effort at all, but it's quite fun.
I don't know how much work it would have taken to do that. I don't know.
Have you still got those goggles on?
Changing the colours? Yeah, I've still got them on.
You can take them off now.
I know, but you can see the invisible people when you got them on.
This is another Time Splitters 3 references this level, actually.
Which one's that?
It's towards the end of the game where you go into an underground ship, actually. Just like this. You go into an underwater sort of base, and it's very 1900s inspired. It's actually like an early Bioshock. Yeah. With giant... It's got robot Louis Stevenson in it. Giant robot.
Whoosh.
Yeah, ideally, I would have turned these goggles off a long time ago.
You see this? Look how dark it is here. It's crazy.
Yeah, this is how dark it was on my TV, but it's meant to be, isn't
it? Yeah,
it just
makes it a lot easier if you have them on, see?
No, I don't know. It's debatable.
that wasn't a good example of how easy it was, but it's okay now. I got to grips with it.
I like how these guys look like Mario with firepower.
Yeah, they do. The white and red.
I don't know if that's intentional, but that's what I thought.
No, they're just meant to be mechanics or something, aren't they?
With guns.
Not like, you know, spaceship mechanics, not like car mechanics. They're not going to fix your Mini.
Well, I tried fixing your sink, but I shot it instead because it was a nightmare.
Okay, we'll call them engineers then. Mechanical engineers. That makes them sound a bit better, doesn't it?
It means it sounds like they work on engineers.
It doesn't.
I'll fix your engineer for you. This reminds me of Independence Day.
The bit where...
Just when they're in the alien ship towards the end.
Yeah. I haven't seen Independence Day in ages. The film's Rob's.
It is. So, I remember...
I liked it when I was younger, but I watched it again when I was out, and it's so, like, corny.
It is very corny, but... Yeah. I don't know. I think it's just because of that one epic scene. That like brief moment where you see like the White House and then the whole like city just being blasted. That was awesome. That still is. Yeah. But that's all it is.
The only problem with that is that they showed that about 20 times in the trailer before the movie came out.
You saw the
best
bit.
And it's on the
film.
Front of the box of the VHS and DVD and stuff. That's the best part.
Well, there you go.
There you go. A lot of trailers do that, though, don't they?
They do, unfortunately.
A lot of trailers, like fucking... what's it called? Oh, Jesus Christ. Paranormal Activity 3 or 4, it was? Where they, like, there was stuff in the trailer that wasn't in the movie. Like, some really good-looking bits, and they just weren't in the movie at all. I think it was number 3.
Chances are it's because the trailers were made long before the film was even finished.
Yeah, before it was edited, yeah. I love this gun, by the way. It's awesome.
It's pretty good, I just don't like the psychedelic colours, man. Hey, you got him.
Yeah,
well played.
Right, him being there. Hey, how did he know I was aiming at him? He doesn't know.
Where are they going? They don't even know. Oh, shots.
Bam!
He's aiming right at you. He knows where you are.
Blam! Sorry if you're bored of this bit, guys. I seem to remember me spending a lot of time looking through this gun. I like follow the corridors.
That's quite
cool.
It does make the
game a lot easier.
I didn't do this at all, but I think this was the last mission I did on Perfect Agent, actually.
Oh, really?
I finished it. I think it was the last
one. I don't understand why you stopped. It's dreadful, this mission. I hate it. Goes on forever, and it's so, like, the environment is so bland looking. It's a good weapon. I liked using it in multiplayer, which I told you when we were playing it, but I remember when you tried it, you were like, what? You can't see nothing!
You can't, it's like, just a mesh of colour.
Yeah, but
I think it's because there's a better one in Red Faction. But Red Faction one is quite, like, I think when you use the one in Red Faction, you can see everybody from everywhere straight away. Like, you don't have to zoom in to different layers, which makes it an absolutely incredible gun.
Look at me, I'm just like following this corridor down.
I can barely interpret the corridor.
Yeah, you can. Look, it's going down, see? And then it sort of stops and you pull it out a bit and it's good. See that? It's awesome. You get to that. I think this bit where I stopped. I don't think you can go much further than this.
Yeah.
I know, sorry, my bad.
I don't think there's much
there. I remember when I first did this, I got confused because I shot one of the aliens in the... There's aliens in those tanks or whatever they are.
Yeah.
I shot one and I didn't... Did I shoot one? Yeah. I got to the place and I didn't realise why there was only one and not two at one point. And I thought, wow, I accidentally shot it from this point. But I'm not doing that here. There we go, people. It's over now. Thankfully, I've killed most of the people. Hopefully, anyway. This bit does look pretty cool, but... Doesn't make
this bit reminds
sense.
Me of Resident Evil 5, for some reason.
The bit
there's
where
that elevator monster.
Yeah. I get what you mean.
Bit of a stretch, but...
I got it when you said it. I understood it, so it's not too much of a stretch, Dane. Zoom, 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 zoom. See, it's just a boring mission. It's boring to watch.
I'm just like, maybe it's because I haven't played it for a while, but I don't remember this area. I don't remember these.
Destroy these. You have to destroy them to finish the mission.
Maybe this is the mission I stopped on then.
Oh, those little tiny critters, they're annoying. Yeah, because they're like the energy source, you have to take them out.
I see.
Yeah, they are little buggers, tiny versions. This mission will always remind me of the Charlie Brooker series, that Black Mirror, because I watched the second series of it while I was doing this mission and the next one. So it's always just going to remind me of that now.
The Blob reminds me of Muse's latest album, which is annoying because whenever I listen to that Muse album, I think of The Blob too. I don't like it. I don't like it anymore.
Yeah. Whenever I play, I had a weird one. I recently got. Do you ever play the game Guitaru Man?
PS2.
I recently played it again on the PSP, which is exactly the same game. And for some reason, when I first played it, the first level. Well, actually, it's the second level. It was a demo level, but it's like you're fighting in this city kind of thing, and it reminded me of an argument between Fraser and Jessica when they were going out with each other in like year 9 or 10. And I played it the other day and it instantly shot back in my head again, and it was like I could remember the argument word for word, and it was like year 9 or something. We're about 14.
12 years ago, nearly half your life ago.
I could just remember, I was just going through what they were saying to each other and how stupid it was sounding. It was really weird.
Oh dear.
Yeah, that's one I've got on me.
That is a horrible one.
Every time I play that mission, it just makes me think of them, and they haven't been together for years. Blam!
Yeah, I don't remember any of this, so I clearly haven't done this.
What do you have to do in the special raging version then? Just get to the end.
Well, you skip all this, you go, like... You have to go to that room where you, it's that really big open room where you have a computer that Elvis works on while you keep the little critters away from him. And you defend him there for a few minutes, and then you go to the laptop, yeah, and it takes all of, like, 5 minutes to do the whole thing.
Yeah, see, there's those little aliens I was talking about. I obviously shot one of them at one point too early. Yeah, there you go, take them out, see? But I don't know what bit you're talking about with the little laptop and stuff. Is that now? I don't know.
That's how the mission ends, isn't it? Dr. Carroll, the
laptop. Yeah, here we go, yeah.
It's a completely different level on the harder difficulty.
What am I looking at? Oh, I'm getting out the thing.
Here goes.
I hope
Datadyne haven't done anything to prevent this.
Where does that go?
There's a little slot on the back at the top.
But it doesn't go in the slot.
Oh, right, yeah, it's just an animation problem, isn't it?
Whoa, what happened there? Okay, you're going to have to tell me when this finishes, because for some reason it's completely skipped the end of it for me.
Oh, don't worry, you got another 2 minutes of blind.
What's happening, Dave? What's happening?
Dr. Carroll, the laptop man, is back.
Back. What do you mean? He's back for a bit, isn't he?
It's really weird because it has female eyes but sounds like a very camp man.
Yeah, it's true.
Maybe they ran out of female employees at Rare at the time to do it.
Love the mission after the music, sorry, as you're escaping the ship. I do like that.
Goodbye, Joanna Dark. Objective 4 complete. The music, yeah, as you're escaping, it's
awesome,
very Goldeneye.
Yeah, it does sound Goldeneye, sure. Good times. Meow, meow,
meow! I don't know if it's the same guy who works on the music on these two, Goldeneye and Perfect Dark, who does Time Splitters music, but if it is, he's a legend.
He's good. Little cat choir.
Graham Norgate.
Didn't he release all the time splitting music to public release?
I don't know if he did it, but there is a website where you can get it.
Website did it.
It's absolutely amazing, though. Some of the music on Time Splitters is like some of the best video game music ever.
Good times.
Yay! Objective 5 complete.
Blam! Whole thing's blowing up. So I reloaded the video, by the way, so I can kind of see what's going on.
Oh, that's good of you, that's good of you. So how long we got now?
But yeah.
Mission 7, 8 and 9 left.
Yeah, last mission coming up.
And they're all quite short, aren't they? They're all single-parter missions.
Yep, they are indeed. Okay, guys, so thanks for watching.